Hello friends, good morning, good afternoon. In this session, we are going to learn Boolean data type, date data type, and binary data type in SQL Server. So what is Boolean data type? We are using the bit as a data type, means there is a two values like true or false. Means suppose there is a one act as a true and zero act as a false. So let's start in the practical. This is the variable is graduate. Suppose we have to identify that person is graduated or not. Means there are two state, either yes or no. So we are defining it as a bit data type, and I am assigning zero value, means he is not graduate. And first of all, I declared that particular variable and with a data type, and I am assigning value 0 to that particular variable, and I am selecting that variable. So I am getting the 0, yes. And what is the if else loop? Means if is graduate is equal to 1, then we can print or select as a graduate candidate. Or if he is not graduate, then we are selecting a statement as ungraduate candidate. Correct, ungraduate candidate. And suppose I am setting the value as a 1, then we will get graduate candidate. Okay, and in interview you will get the different twist of the question. Like suppose you right now I am assigning 0 or 1 value, but interviewer may ask there is a 254, 255 or whatever number, means, and they are saying, yeah, what will be the output? So the output will be a 1. Why? Because if there is a condition is equal to 0, then we will get 0, otherwise we will get the true, means 1. Suppose there is a minus 14, 454, then there is also 1. So it is the interview point of view. Next one is a date data type in SQL Server. So when we require date data type, when we have to store date, time, or there is a condition where we have to set the date with offset, at that time we are using this date data type. So let's see in practical. First of all, what is the select date get date? Select get date is the function with the help of we can retrieve the current date. Yeah, there is a date. These are the data type, means date, time, small date time, date time, date time 2, and date time offset. We have to store a date only. At that time we can use the date data type, means there is a format is the YYMM, means 4 times YYMM and DD. And there is a time means hour, minute, second, then millisecond. And after that small date time, there is a date and time, but second till the second. And there is a date time, in date time up to the 3 milliseconds. And there is a date time 2, means up to the 7 milliseconds. If we have to store the offset value, means plus 530, here you can see there is a Chennai Kolkata, means it is the Indian, based on the region, the offset is we are getting, and so that offset value we can store in the database. And there is a data type is date time offset. Yeah, let's see other means data type in detail. So what I am doing here, means here is the variable current date, and I am setting the data type as a date, and I am assigning the current date is equal to get date. It means current date I am getting this date, but I have to pick only date. At that time I can use the date data type. So let's see. Yeah, this is the date. Correct, same as per the time, means if I require the time from that particular date, at that time I will use the time data type, correct? Okay. And small date time will occupy 4 byte in memory in the database, and date time eight byte, it will save up to the second only, and it will 3 milliseconds. If we don't require all the details about the millisecond, then we are fine with this, correct? So it is the better one, means as compared to the date time, we can use the small date time when there is a no necessity of milliseconds. At that time we can save the space as well. So let's start about the small date time. So we are getting the time till second, correct? And there is a date time, we will get the date time till millisecond, and but three digit of the particular second. And there is a 7 digit date time to, it is miss date time to will occupy more space as compared to the date time, because it saving more digit in millisecond. 7 digit miss accuracy is more. And there is a date time offset, as I said, there is a +530 miss India region. Based on that we are getting the time. So 7 second digit plus that offset as well. Next one is binary data type. First of all, we have to understand when that binary data type used in practical. When suppose there is a PDF file, Word file, or image I have to save in the database, at that time I can use this data type. So I will show you one simple example. This is the .NET application, and using that I am storing the file into the database and retrieving that one. So let's start. There is a new, then there is a person as Sagar, and vehicle, okay, and get file. First of all I will create a one file, notepad. Okay, vehicle log, and let's say I am putting some words in this and save it in document, vehicle log, save, correct, close. I have to attach that file, correct, get file, then go to the document, there is a text file and vehicle log. Okay, and where is that path, if we have to mention or not mention, it is dependent on me. And sample, save, correct. So this file is saved, and let's say we will search it at here, vehicle. Okay, click on it, and view file. So we are getting this file. So let's see how we are saving this file in database. Here is the one table, file attachment is the table, save data is the database, and in that I created the one table, file attachment, and file attachment having the different columns. Like suppose I am retrieving the today's file, means what files are saved on today, and based on that I am retrieving only that files. So before few seconds we checked, there is a vehicle.txt we inserted from the front end, means .NET application, and yeah, there is a file data. File data, this is nothing but the binary format. So if we click on file attachment and Alt F1, there is a button we have to press, Alt F1, so you will get complete information about the table, means what is table name, when it was created, then there is a what are the different columns, and based on column length as well, it is scaling, nullable, all this information you will get, and there is a identity, then GUID is available or not, then there is a index and constant as well. Okay, so right now we have to concentrate on how that binary data stored into the table. So n varchar and minus one, it means max, and there is a file data, correct? If we execute it, means we are selecting, so file data, it is nothing but the var binary max. If you have to see, then table and file attachment, and in that you will see file data and var binary max. So what is the flow? Means from .NET application, you are inserting that particular file with the help of get file. You can select that file, and after that it is inserting. So means there is a get file, then stored procedure is called, and at that time when you are saving save button, there is a behind of it, there is a one stored procedure, we can say insert. This is a stored procedure, insert file attachment, and it having a data type like a var binary max. And you, if you wanna see the code of it in .NET, then this is the sample, means this is the image data. Image data is nothing but the reading the path, means from that particular file path it reads the file, and that image data is the name, and that is nothing but the object, and that object is we are getting the binary data, correct? And that binary data passed to the stored procedure, and it will insert into the file data. Okay, and till the database and table insert the data like this. And okay, and next one is how we are retrieving from database to the UI or application. So there is a view button, means here you can see when you click on view, so it retrieving, means at the back end there is a binary data, and that binary data come into the actual original file. So with the help of stored procedure, we are retrieving this, and means that data is again get back to in a original file, means whatever that file we have, either image, text, or a word file, txt file, or a pdf file, we will get that. Okay, yeah, three types in binary data type. One is the binary, and then is the var binary and var binary max. It will allocate binary 10, means in the background it will allocate 10 bytes fixed memory in the database, or we can say hard disk. And there is a var binary 500, means based on the size, means suppose there is a 5 characters in it, or at that time it will allocate 5, and max to max there is a 500. This is the purpose of the var binary. And var binary max, it is depending on the size of the particular file, or we can say suppose that file is a very small, at that time it will consume the less memory in the database. And if that file is greater, at that time based on that particular file size, it will consume the memory in the database. In the next session we will see about the other data types like a cursor, unique identifier, SQL variant. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you really like it, this video, then please give me a one like on this video and share it so that other will know, and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much. Bye bye.